Hello friends, welcome to Chemistry Gems. In this video we are learning some basic concepts of chemistry. This is the chapter 1 of class 11 and in this chapter our topic is law of chemical combination. So there are two previous lecture, so link given in the description box, so check out these videos. So start this video with law of chemical combination. So there are various elements present, so their combination of these elements, so they form compound. And this compound is governed by some following basic law, and there are five basic laws are present. First is law of conservation of mass, and second is law of definite proportion, and third is law of multiple proportion, and fourth law is Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volume, and fifth law is Avogadro law. So start with the law of conservation of mass. So in which law of conservation of mass, so this law is governed by Antonin Levi in 1789. So he performed a careful experimental studies on the combustion reaction, and he reached a conclusion that no change in the mass during any process. So this is the law of conservation of mass. So their conclusion will be that matter can neither be created and nor be destroyed. For example, combustion reaction of methane. So there is CH4 plus O2 and there are two molecules and they form CO2 plus H2O. So in the starting the reaction there are four molecules of hydrogen are present, and at the end of the there are also four hydrogen molecules are present, and in this one carbon molecule is present, and after the process one carbon molecule is present, and there are four oxygen atoms are present, and in this two, and there is also two oxygen, that is 2 plus 2, 4 oxygen are present. So there can neither be mass created or nor be destroyed. So we can say that total mass after the reaction and before the reaction are remains same. Now we move on to the law of definite proportion. Law of definite proportion. So this law is governed by French chemist Joseph Proust, and this is also called Proust's law, and sometimes it's also called constant composition. And from the name of the constant composition, it shows that their components are fixed. So it states that in a given chemical compound, their contain its component are in a fixed ratio by their mass. So Proust worked on two cupric carbonate, in which first is natural and the other was synthetic. So he found that their component element have in same ratio, like that there are natural sample present and there are synthetic sample present. So in the so there is the percentage of copper and there is a percentage of carbon and there is percentage of oxygen. So the percentage of copper is 57.35 and in the synthetic sample there will be 57.35 and the percentage of carbon is 9.74 and there also will be 9.74 and the percentage of O2 is 3.97. So through this example he shows that in which component are present in fixed ratio. In this is a natural sample and this is a synthetic sample, but in this component are in fixed ratio. Now we move on to the law of multiple proportion. So this law is proposed by Dalton's in 1803. And according to this law, if there are two elements combined, they form more than one compound. And in this, the mass of one element is combined with the fixed mass of the other element. And in this, ratio R as a small whole number. For example, if there are hydrogen react with oxygen, so they form two products. First is water and second is hydrogen peroxide. Like that, H2 plus O, they form water. And the other is H2 plus O2, so they form H2O2. So in this, there are two molecules of hydrogen and the atomic mass is 1. So there is 2 into 1. So there is 2 gram of mass. And the oxygen has atomic mass 16 gram. And the total mass of this is 18 gram. So hydrogen has, there are 2 molecules, so there are 2 gram. And the oxygen has, there are 2 molecules of oxygen and 1 oxygen has mass 16. So 2 molecule has 2 into 16, that is 32, and there is 32 plus 2, that is 34 gram. So in this, oxygen has combined with hydrogen, and in this oxygen has, does not fix mass, but hydrogen has fixed mass. So their ratio will be oxygen has 16:32. So there is 1:2 is present. Now we move on to the Gay-Lussac's law of gaseous volume. So this law is proposed by Gay-Lussac in 1808. And he observed that when the gases are combined or the gas is produced in a chemical reaction, so they do a simple ratio by volume of all the gases present at the same temperature and pressure. For example, if there are 100 ml of hydrogen react with 50 ml of oxygen, so they form 100 ml of water vapor. So in this, the ratio will be quite 100:50, so it will be 2:1. And this method is also as same as definite proportion method. Now we move on to the Avogadro law. Avogadro law. In 1811, Avogadro proposed that equal volume of all the gases at same temperature and pressure, so they contain equal number of molecules. And Avogadro made difference between atom and the molecules. And consider an example, hydrogen react with oxygen, so they form water. If there are 2 volume of hydrogen react with 1 volume of oxygen, so they form 2 volume of water and without leaving unreactive oxygen. And in this, Dalton and others believe that atoms of same kind cannot combine. And in this, hydrogen and oxygen of 2 atoms cannot exist. And this article of Avogadro published in Journals de Physique. And he did not give much support at that time. But after 50 years in 1860, their importance in Avogadro work. So thank you so much guys for watching this video. Hit the like button, share with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.